Good afternoon, students. In the previous class, we have seen about the different types of mask layers, that is N diffusion, P diffusion, polysilicon, and metal. And at the same time, what are the stick diagrams and what are the different rules for stick diagrams? That means we have seen rule one, rule two, rule three, like the that is nothing but when two or more sticks of the same type cross or touch each other, that represents the electrical contact. So these rules are very important while drawing the stick diagrams for both normal NMOS transistors and at the same time CMOS transistors. Next, when two or more sticks of different type cross or touch each other, there is no electrical contact. If we require the electrical contact, we have to place. So, and another, the rule number three is when a polysilicon or poly is poly crosses the diffusion, it represents a transistor. Okay. So if you use while crossing the poly with the diffusion, if you use the contact cut, that becomes what? That is not a transistor formation. And another thing is, this is for, these three rules are for applicable for both NMOS and CMOS. But the fourth rule is applicable for only CMOS circuits, because the CMOS consists of PMOS and NMOS transistors. That means pull-up network and pull-down networks it consists of. So because of that, to differentiate or to isolate the P-type materials or P-type transistors in and N-type transistors or NMOS transistors, we have used the demarcation line. Okay, so that's what here in a CMOS demarcation line is drawn to avoid the touching of P diffusion with N diffusion. All PMOS must lies on one side of the line and NMOS will lies on the other side of the line. So this is the PMOS and this one is the NMOS. Now we have seen the very important thing here, that is nothing but how these colors, how these sticks diagrams will be represented with respect to the NMOS process and at the same time CMOS process. Okay, so here that representation we can call as encodings for NMOS process. Similarly, we have encoding for CMOS process here. Okay, so I will explain here today about both the stick diagrams and how you can draw the layouts also. That means the layout representations for them. Okay, so here the stick diagram for N diffusion here is that is nothing but green color. And here also it consists of a box, that is these lines we have. Here stand lines like this. This is totally green. So this is green representation in terms of stick diagram, and this one is in terms of the layouts. Okay, so similarly we have the polysilicon. This is for NMOS process what we are going to use, and out of this will be applicable for both NMOS and CMOS, but some will be changed, that is contact cuts and diffusions and all those things will change. Okay, so here we have the green. Green is represented for N diffusion. N diffusion is represented in terms of stick diagram as a stick with green color we are representing here. And at the same time, N plus active also. N plus active means more what we call more doping concentration. What I have explained in the class, that is source and drain will be formed with N plus regions. Okay. So next year, it is very important because it is layouts. For the stick diagram information here, we can represent in terms of also layouts. Or the circuit representation will represent in terms of circuit diagrams, stick diagrams, and at the same time, in terms of layout. So why you have to draw a layout diagram or layout representation for N diffusion? So you have to consider this. That means this representation we have. Okay. So here, we have this green color box, and in that one we are using slash, okay, forward slash lines. Okay, next we have with red representation. Red is nothing but for polysilicon. So these are the layers what we have considered previously, that is NMOS, N diffusion, P diffusion, polysilicon, and at the same time metal. So here also we have the red. Red is represented with a polysilicon, that is polysilicon is represented in both stick diagram and at the same time in layouts. The color that is used is nothing but red, but here we have is this box, square box, rectangular box we are going to use. In this one, backslash you have to use for the representation of polysilicon. Okay. What I told, three layers we have, that is nothing but antifusion, that is diffusion layers, polysilicon and metal. Out of that, what we have seen, antifusion, we have seen both in stick diagram representation and in layout representation. So this color coding or color representation is very, very important, because by using this only, we are going to draw for all the digital circuits, whatever we have, and NAND, NOR, any circuit, any digital circuit, we can represent it with this stick diagram and at the same time this layout. Okay, so without knowing this color representation, we can't do the stick diagram drawing and at the same time layout drawing. Okay, so next what we have is your blue. In the stick diagram representation, blue is used for metal one representation. We have different types of metal layers, that is metal one, metal two, like that. For metal one, we'll see next. So metal one is used, metal one, blue color is a blue color stick is used to represent the metal. Okay, metal one. And now if you observe this one here also, it is very, very important here. So this one is the box, rectangular box, what we have. But here we are using straight lines to represent the metal. Okay, that is metal one. So if you observe these things, you will get the clarity. That is antifusion is for green. Green is for antifusion. And at the same time here also, layout diagram also, we can use the same thing here. Next one, red is used for polysilicon representation, both in stick and at the same time layout representation. But the layout representation will use the square rectangular box with the backslashes. And now we have what? Metal one. Metal one is nothing but blue color. We can use metal one. Blue is used. And here we can use the box. And in that one, we are going to use the straight lines. Okay, with blue color. So this is the representation of three layers, three main important layers, what we have here. That is diffusion layer, polysilicon layer, and metal layers, both in stick diagram and at the same time layouts. Now, contact cut, what we have to use. Contact cut is nothing but circle is, black color circle is there, here we have, and it is square. In layout, it will be different. Okay. So here in block, stick diagram representation, so suppose you have to represent a contact cut. Contact cut means what? You have to make a contact between the two layers like this. Okay, so this one is one layer and this one is one layer. This one, between these two, we have to make a contact. That is, this red is nothing but polysilicon and this green is nothing but diffusion and diffusion. So if you want to make a contact cut, contact between them, actually it will, without this contact cut, it will form a transistor. If you represent this circle with black color, so that will represent the contact cut or the contact established between the two layers. So that's what here you are going to represent. Suppose between two layers, if you want to make a contact, that in stick diagram, you have to use this circle. And in the layout diagram, what we have to use is a square box with the block color. Okay, with block color, you have to use the square box. So this is the representation of contact cut. Okay, so this one is over glass. This is not applicable for stick diagram, but it is applicable for layout diagram. We'll see one by one. Next one here, NMOS only. That means implantation, that is N diffusion. For diffusion for depletion transistor. So you have to represent this one, depletion transistor. And in the layouts also, we can represent for depletion MOSFET. We have to use this square box with yellow color. Next one is we have NMOS only for brown. Brown is used. Here we have used contact cut, but here we are going to use another, we are going to define another contact that is nothing but buried contact. Okay, so generally buried contact is used to connect the materials here, layers. Okay, so buried contact that will be represented with this color, that is orange color here. So next one is what? Buried contact means you have to represent a square box that is with cross mark. So this is NMOS only, that is brown in stick diagram. Here also we have NMOS only. We are going to use the buried contact here. What is buried contact and all those things we'll see in the next coming class. This is about the encoding process for encoding for NMAS process. Okay, only NMAS, that is stick diagram, and at the same time layouts representation. Now we'll go with how we can draw a n-type enhancement transistor. Already we have seen this one. N-type enhancement MOSFET means I already told when a transistor will form, when the transistor will form whenever an n diffusion or p diffusion crosses with the polysilicon. So here we are going to define the stick diagram for n-type enhancement mode transistor. So that's why this green color, that is nothing but n diffusion, is crossed with the polysilicon. So it represents what? N-type enhancement mode transistor. Similarly, here symbolic representation is also there. Already I have shown this MOSFET means it consists of source and drain. In between that, we have the gate. Okay, so this represents the source and this represents the drain. We have the gate. Okay, so this is symbolic representation of n-type enhancement MOS transistor or MOS transistor. Next one is what? N-type depletion MOS transistor, NMOS. So what I told here, this one is nothing but what? Enhancement MOSFET. But depletion MOSFET means we are going, the extra thing is nothing but channel we will place between the source and drain. So that's why we are going to use this one, this yellow color representation, that is nothing but implant. Okay, so this represents this yellow color representation, yellow color box will represent the n-type depletion mode transistor. Now what we have here, that is the same symbol you can use with NMOS n-type enhancement mode transistor is extended with the yellow color box. Okay, so you can observe all these things here. This one is nothing but, so red color is what? Red color is polysilicon and green color is n diffusion. So I am using here, that is green color, that is with a forward slash, and it is crossed with the polysilicon, that is represented with a square box with a backslash. Okay, so this is nothing but n-type enhancement transistor. But what we have to use, n-type depletion mode transistor means, so the same thing will be repeated. There is no change in the depletion, what we call and diffusion, and at the same time polysilicon, but only one difference is there. Because it is depletion mode transistor, we have to represent the implant. Implant is more we have in width as compared with the stick diagram width here. So like this we will represent. So this is the representation of NMOS enhancement mode transistor and n-type depletion mode transistor in NMOS encoding process. Okay, so till now only we have seen NMOS encoding process. Now we are going with the CMOS. Okay, encoding for CMOS process. So encoding for CMOS process means it consists of So CMOS consists of what? Here I already yesterday I have represented this. So this one is PMOS and this one is NMOS, and this is what? VDD, and this one is what? VSS. So here it is NMOS. It is of PMOS. Okay, now how this will be represented in both in stick diagram format and at the same time layout format. So if you observe this one, here we have is n diffusion, that is green, and polysilicon, that is red, and blue is metal one, and block color is contact cut, and gray is for ore glass. Okay, so here we are using the same thing for NMOS process. These will be applicable for CMOS process also. Okay, the same NMOS process encoding is applicable for the CMOS process. There we didn't discuss any P diffusion or metal 2 and all those things we didn't discuss. But whatever the discussion we have done for NMOS process, is applicable for CMOS process also up to this point, because that's why it is given or it is represented like this. Whenever you are representing an NMOS transistor, so you have to follow the same rules. There is nothing but N-diffusion green, and red is polysilicon, blue is metal one, and black is contact cut, and gray is over glass. So the same thing is applicable for both stick diagram and at the same time layout whenever you are doing with the N-MOSFET. Okay, N-MOS transistor. Now, what we have to learn now here is N-MOS is over, because we have drawn, we have seen that N-MOS encoding process. But what about this P-MOS? What about this P-MOS? And at the same time, we have to isolate this P-MOS and N-MOS. Okay, then how you can do? Isolation means in the rule 4, I have given that. Isolation means we have to draw a demarcation line. Okay, we have to draw a demarcation line between PMOS and NMOS. So here PMOS is called as pull-up transistor and NMOS is called as pull-down transistor. Okay, pull-up and pull-down transistor. Here, if you consider NMOS CMOS inverter, the basic circuit of CMOS technology, if you consider NOR gate or NAND gate, so here we have network, pull-up network and pull-down network will be present. Okay. So that is what here pull up and pull down means. Okay. So now how you can represent or how you can draw a stick diagram and layout for this P-type and MOSFET or PMOS. Okay. So PMOS means what? Which diffusion we require? PMOS means in the transistor, we require source and drain are of P-type material and substrate is of N-type material. Okay. So source and drain are here, if you consider this one is the transistor, here we'll place a source and drain, source of P-type material, that is P+, and drain is also of P-type, and this one is substrate is N-type. So here we have P-type to form the PMOS transistor. So we have to encode the PMOS also. Therefore, here P-diffusion is used, which color? That is yellow color stick. P-diffusion is used. There is yellow color here, and but here if you consider this one here, it is of we are using the this box to represent the P+ or P-active. Okay, so that is what yellow color representation. Previously N diffusion means green color we have represented. Here for P diffusion we have to represent with the yellow color. Okay, now here what we have is, whenever you are using P+ mask, means mask you have to use in CMOS circuit while doing the fabrication. So we have to use the mask. So that mask representation also we can represent it with this cell over. Right? Next one, metal 2. So we have discussed P-diffusion, N-diffusion, metal 1. And polysilicon is always red. There is no change for PMOS and NMOS or CMOS. Polysilicon is always red. Okay, but what is the difference between here NMOS and PMOS? Means NMOS will be represented with green and PMOS will be represented with yellow. Next one is what? Dark blue or purple. So the metal 2 we are going to use, that is metal 2 color is what? Purple. Okay, dark blue or purple. So how you can represent this? How you can represent this is nothing but, so for metal 1 we have used the For metal one, we have used the blue, but for metal two, we are going to use the blue with the vertical lines. For metal two, we have to use the straight lines, that is horizontal lines. Okay, so this is the representation of metal two. Our next one is vias. So similarly, contact cut, what we are using here, vias is also there. We have vias also well represented with the block circles. Black color circle in stick diagram encoding, but here we are going to use these wires with this square box. Okay, so next one is demarcation line. We have here P-well, we have N-well process and P-well process and twin-top process like that. Whenever you are going to use the P-well, means you have to use the demarcation line, color is brown, and here also we are going to use the square box for that one. Here we are going to use the square box in layout. Okay, so next one, black color is used for VDD or VSS. This one is very, very important. So This one is whenever you are going to represent a VDD or VSS contact, that is power supply. So what we have to use here is, what we have to use here is the cross mark is used, the black color cross mark is used for VDD. And at the same time, to represent this one in the layout form. Layout form means you have to represent VDD like this. So a metal on that one, you have to use the polysilicon. And we are having this this one as the box, that is block box here we are going to use. The next one is what VSS here. VSS means VDD and VSS, for both we will use the cross marking stick diagram. For VSS, we have to represent this yellow box. Okay, this yellow block. Both are same, but here we have to represent the VSS as yellow block, the extra one. So this is encoding for CMOS process. Okay, so you can observe here how you can encode, that is CMOS and PMOS transistors here. N-type means here green and red here we have, and P-type means we have, I already told that only enhancement transistors we are going to use here. So now you can observe this here. This LOE represents the P-diffusion, and it is crosses with what? It crosses with the red polysilicon. So it is nothing but the P-type enhancement transistor. Now we have green and red we have. Green and red color we have is nothing but N-type enhancement mass transistor. But here the very important thing is, you can observe that P plus mask here we are going to use. This red is polysilicon and this green is the diffusion. But here if you use this yellow color, that is P plus mask, so that will represent the P-type transistor in the layout. So you can observe this. So green color with the in the layout with yellow color box. So that's what here we are going to use, green color, that is represents the, with yellow representation represents the P diffusion process. Okay, so this is the formation of encoding for CMOS process. Okay. So similarly, we will go with encoding for BJT and MOSFETs here. You can observe here the polysilicon 2. Polysilicon 1 is used for red color. Polysilicon 2 is where we have, that is orange color. And we can represent bipolar transistor as like this with the symbol. Okay. So these things we'll see in the next one. So now we'll go with the stick diagrams here. One second, I will remove it. Now we are going with the stick diagram basic steps. What we have, how we can draw the stick diagram for NMOS and at the same time for CMOS. Okay. So generally, if you observe, normally the first step is to draw the two parallel metal VDD and ground rails. That means what, if you consider, an inverter, suppose. An inverter. I am not using here CMOS inverter circuit. So I am going to use this one. So this is VDD and VSS. Or we can also say that ground. Okay. So this is the input what we have to provide. This one is NMOS transistor, and at the same time, this one is also NMOS transistor. NMOS depletion MOSFET here. So the above one is NMOS depletion MOSFET, and below one is NMOS enhancement transistor. So this is also a form. This will also form an inverter circuit. This will also form an inverter circuit. Okay. So what we are going to use here, this one is NMOS depletion MOSFET and this one is NMOS enhancement MOSFET. Instead of this, we can also use both NMOS. In CMOS circuits, we are going to use the, instead of this PMOS transistor, pull-up network. But here we are going to use in NMOS a basic inverter circuit, we have to use the depletion MOSFET as the pull-up transistor and the pull-down transistor is enhancement transistor. Okay, so here this one is one power line and this one is power line, another power line. VDD is the power supply and at the same time this one is also ground. Okay, so these two will be parallel always. That's why these are called as power supply rails. So the railway track will be like this, right? Okay, two tracks will be like this parallelly always. Similarly, here VDD and VSS both are in parallel. So that's why normally the first step is to draw the two parallel metal VDD and ground rails, and there should be enough space between them to accommodate the other elements. So this one is what here. This one is the thing but VDD and VSS. In between them, we have the two transistors. So we have to place them. That's why we have to make some space between the VDD and VSS. Next one is what? Active green path must be drawn for required transistor that are N diffusion. That means if the transistor is NMOS, because both are NMOS transistors. So what I have to do here, I will draw here itself. So here I am considering that two parallel lines are put, two parallel sticks I am taking here. So in between that, we have to use this one as N-type. Okay, and diffusion. Normally, the first step is we are representing this one as VDD and this one is VSS. Between them, I have to use the contact cut. So I will use this one like this, between this and this. Because in stick diagram, the contact cut is a black color circle. That's why I'm using circle here to make a contact between this metal and at the same time, this one is the metal, right? Metal and the diffusion, okay? So now after that, we have to indicate the contact cuts. So I have done the same thing here. Active paths must be drawn for required transistor that are N-diffusion. N-diffusion I have drawn. And in this one, I have to connect metal with this diffusion and metal with this diffusion. That's why I'm using the circle here, contact cut circles. Okay, next we have to represent poly cross active where transistor is required. Okay, I have NMOS depletion and I have NMOS enhancement transistor. So if I cross this one with polysilicon here, and here also, if I cross the polysilicon here, but what we have to do, we have to make this one. So this is nothing but the depletion, NMOS depletion transistor, and this will form this. So this one is the polysilicon, poly, and this one is also a poly. So this one is polysilicon and this one is polysilicon, and it is processed with the diffusion, means it will form N diffusion, means it will form NMOS transistor. But here we are using implant, that square box we are using implant. So it will form NMOS depletion MOSFET. Without square box, it will form what? NMOS transistor, enhancement transistor. Okay, next we have to represent poly red cross active, and for depletion mode transistor, the other required implant. Required implant means this one is the depletion MOSFET. So that's why I have drawn this one. Okay, for depletion MOSFET. Label each transistor with LW ratio. That means the length and width of the channel we have to represent. So this is the formation of how you can form a stick diagram. So I will show these. These are the rules we have. I'll show another diagram here. CMOS we'll see in the next class. Just I will show the stick diagram for this NMOS inverter or inverter circuit we will have. So I have drawn that, but it's not that much of clear. So I will go with this. Like this, the stick diagram will be present. This is for CMOS inverter. Okay. But we'll see the NMOS inverter in the next class. NMOS inverter, AND gate, and OR gate, and all those things we are going to see in the next class. Okay. So all of you once go through, take the Pucknell textbook or go through online these stick diagrams and layouts. So in the next class, I am going to explain about how you can draw the stick diagram for NMAS stick diagram, and at the same time, the basic steps to draw the CMOS circuit stick diagrams. Okay.